I saw Bad Moms tonight, and I honestly have to say it's one of my favorite movies that I've seen in a while. Some people were commenting on my stuff like, okay, well, do a little review. I'm bad at this stuff. Basically, well, I'm not going to give anything away, but I laughed out loud, and like, I'm usually the person in the theater when no one laughs, I laugh, but like, I laughed so many times when other people were laughing. And so that means if other people were laughing, then it was good, because I usually laugh at everything. But other people were laughing. But it was really good. I really liked the movie. I don't know what I'm supposed to say in a review. I laughed a lot, and I checked one text message, and I usually check my phone a lot. So I think that means it's a good sign. I really liked it. I did. I want a guy. I want a guy who doesn't lecture me about getting fit because he knows I'm the shit. I want a guy who doesn't think it's weird that I've had a binky since childhood and I take it with me most places I go. That's actually true. I want a guy who understands that I've been hurt in the past and finds it a little bit cute when I get jealous instead of thinking I'm a crazy bitch. I want a guy who doesn't find it hard to understand that although I'm feminine in certain ways, I'm a top. Like, for real, that's hard to find. I had 5 emails sent to me this morning from 5 different email addresses asking me, Chris, are you really gay? My initial response in my head was, is this really a fucking email? Is this really a fucking question? That ends in a question mark. Who would wonder this enough to even physically click compose email, type in my booking email, which is for work promotions, to inquire to see if I'm really gay? Listen, people, I don't know what is wrong with you. I don't know what is right with you, but I do know one fucking thing. Enough fucking said. Why do y'all worry about who has slept with who? Are you mad because you wasn't invited to the 2-person slumber party? Are you mad because you wasn't invited to the 2-person sleepover, honey? Is that what's really going on? Quit worrying about who in the hell people sleep with. If you were so satisfied with that little teddy bear you're cuddled up with, you wouldn't be worried about who in the hell I'm sleeping with doing the hokey pokey at night. Mind your own panties business, bitch! Gossiping about who I'm hopping into bed with. Well, let me tell you something. When I was hopping in that bed, I dove head first. I likes to get out here and fuck. I sure as hell do, because I'm a responsible motherfucking adult. Now, you mind your own panties businesses. If you're one of them people that say, oh, did you hear who she slept with? Did you hear who he slept with? No, honey. I am almost 29 years old. I don't have any children. I have paid for every car that I have ever owned. I pay my own bills. I pay other people's bills. And I'm a self-made bitch. So if I want to get out here and screw, and if I want to get out here with no strings attached, who the hell are you to tell me that I'm a slut?
I'm not religious, so you can't impose your morality on me. Because I don't think there's any problem with 2 responsible adults getting out here and doing a little bit of fucking.
I fucking said it. I like to fucking fuck. And if you don't like to fucking fuck, get the fucking fuck over the fucking thing. Because I like to get out here and I like to rip the tide a little bit. I like to get out here and sail the high seas. I like to get out here after a long, hard day and get a little bit fucking wild as a motherfucker. It's fun to fuck. Do it responsibly, fucker. These are things that I do that are considered bitchy, but really it's just me having self-respect up in this motherfucker. If I @reply you on Twitter and tell you that you're cute, and you only favorite it and don't respond, I unfollow you. And even if you do respond, if you don't tell me that I'm cute in return, you should be unfollowed. Where's the common courtesy of having eyeballs? If I walk past you in public and I smile and you just go, I usually say, hey, you look like a parrot. Bye. What? That's my way of taking back my smile.
If I let you borrow money and you don't pay me back when you say you will, I have sex with your ex. Payback's a bitch. You should have paid. If you're my friend and you ask me to go somewhere and I tell you I don't want to go, but I'll go to be nice, and you don't let me play my fucking songs on the radio the whole fucking way, I rip your stereo system out of your car and say, well, let me tell you something. These fuckboys is dangerous because they try to fucking hypnotize you and shit. You be mad at them for, like, cheating or texting somebody, and they be like, come on, baby. You ain't gonna be mad at me over that, are you? You know, I was just slipping. I was going through some things. You know I love you. You don't want to leave me, do you? And I'm sitting here like, I walked into this conversation strong as a motherfucker, and now I'm like, the fuck? You like that snake from the Jungle Book. Okay, so Mom sent me a picture of the singer, Liam Payne. Do you think this is me?
Yeah, she was.
Are you, like, you're kidding? You think that's me?
Looks like you.
Look at the eyes, those brown eyes.
What'd you do, put contacts in?
Look at the birthmark on the neck, honey.
You must have had a hickey on your neck. While you're around here every day, it sure looks like you to me.
You don't know the difference between that right there.
You went to Spencer's and got some brown contacts.
I give up. Y'all, excuse the mess in here. I just gave birth a couple weeks ago in here and we ain't cleaned it up yet. But, you know, a new mother's gotta have fun, so I'm about to get my jam on. I'm trying this new thing. It's called frontward twerking. You know, for those of us that got more in the front than the back. I'm gonna play my theme song before I go out tonight and get dirty. Listen, I may not agree with everything Chick-fil-A stands for, but I will agree on this. That's some good Christian chicken. What you looking at me crazy for? They may not support me the right to get married. But they ain't gonna deny me the taste of that good. I'm sorry. It should taste good. Some good Christian chicken. Me and this guy broke up, and he was posting all these really sad statuses afterwards. I'm just like, where was that sadness when you was being a complete dick?
Now you a stab dick? I just don't get it. Like, if you care, show you care when I'm there. After we broke up, I was posting pictures of me doing handstands and the hula hoop and drinking martinis and shit like that. Real delicate shit. Stunting shit. And he was just like, how could you? I was like, how could I what? He was like, present yourself like you're so happy now. I was like, out with what's gone, in with the new thongs. Honey, I'm a new bitch.
Well, sometimes I do waste my evenings getting in little petty arguments with them Hillary supporters, you know, HRC. Well, I do. I get on there and I start arguing with them because I just feel like I'm doing the Lord's work. As I always say, you know, I feel like anyone that's voting for that woman can't know who she is, and I'm going to stand by that, and I'm going to repost all the memes that I can find. I'm just a meme poster. I'm a copy and paster, which is funny because I kind of have a lot in common with what secretaries do. I'm going to copy and paste until my heart's content. I just hope I don't accidentally copy and paste something else I was watching before the argument. But yes, I love to argue with them Hillary supporters. But when they say something about Trump and how he makes rude comments, I don't really respond to that trash. Because I ain't got nothing to say. Hi, y'all. As always, it's your friendly neighbor, Penelope. Excuse the appearance because, well, I've got my tattooed makeup on and it's too early to put my regular makeup on. Well, as y'all know, Hillary was on there giving a speech last night, and she was wearing white. I guess she's trying to purify her image now. That's a lie, too, isn't it? I mean, come on. Do people really believe she's trustworthy now just because she's wearing the color of a bride? She ain't gonna be the bride of America. I mean, I can't believe this. I mean, is it not easy for people to see that? Look at the color she was wearing last night. She's trying to brainwash us into thinking she's pure. She needs to Clorox her image, her reputation. And I didn't hear her talking about nothing. Just saw her up there playing with a bunch of balloons. But of course I didn't watch because Trump told me not to. So.
You really think Donald Trump has the temperament to be commander-in-chief? Donald Trump can't even handle the rough and tumble of a presidential campaign. He loses his cool at the slightest provocation. When he's gotten a tough question from a reporter, when he's challenged in a debate, when he sees a protester at a rally. Imagine, if you dare, imagine him in the Oval Office facing a real crisis. A man you can bait with a tweet is not a man we can trust with nuclear weapons. Donald Trump says he wants to make America great again. Well, he could start by actually making things in America.
Woo, honey, she's reading tonight, yes.
That's right, Hillary.
We face in this election is just as stark when it comes to our national security. For 70 odd minutes, and I do mean odd.
Yes, honey.
And he offered zero solutions.
Right.
But we already know he doesn't believe these things. No wonder he doesn't like talking about his plans. You might have noticed I love talking about mine.
Ha ha! Oh, ha ha!
In my first 100 days, we will work with both parties to pass the biggest investment in new good-paying jobs since World War II. Jobs in manufacturing, clean energy, technology and innovation, small business and infrastructure. If we invest in infrastructure now, we'll not only create jobs today, but lay the foundation for the jobs of the future.
So it's like 10:30 at night. What's my favorite show? The Real Housewives of New York City. I love Ramona, Bethany, all of them. Luann. I don't know why they're my favorite, but they're like just this group of sisters that or aunts that like you never had. I don't know. They're just so funny to me. Can't decide if I want anything to eat, which I'm not complaining. Because like, that's a thing. That's a stop and pause moment. With all the craziness going on in the world, if your biggest problem or whatever is, should I eat? I don't feel like getting up to eat. It kind of makes you realize, oh, that's a good thing. If that's the only thing I have to think about. You know what I'm saying? So the bad times make you grateful for the okay times. It makes the okay times great perspective. I do think I'm going to eat, though.
I honestly believe that a lot of you don't even believe what you're saying. I think you're just trying to argue. That's what I think it is. Because it's not relatable to me. I can't relate with wanting to argue. I'm a peacemaker. I am. So I think a lot of this political mumbo-jumbo stuff is just so you can argue. I do. It's stupid. So whatever. Honestly, I see so many posts of so many people arguing about so much stuff, and I'm just like, wow, like, I wish I could care that much about stuff like that. Like, I just don't. Like, why do you care that much about stuff that I don't care that much about? Like, I wish I could relate with caring that much about stuff. Like, I don't know. I just think people want to argue. Like, I don't know. Maybe because I don't have an opinion of my own that, like, I can't relate to, and it's just not hashtag relatable to me. Maybe that's what it is. Maybe I think that people are troublemakers who try to talk about political stuff because, like, I just don't have an opinion of my own, so, like, whatever, it's not hashtag relatable. I just, like, want to change the subject every time someone brings up politics because it has to be an argument. Like, it has to be. Like, it has to be. It has to be.
Now listen to me. I respect everyone's opinion to vote for who they want to vote for. I really do. Honestly, I do. But as soon as, you know, I find out you're voting for Hillary, for some reason, I can't just talk about what I don't like about her policies. I have to start personally attacking you, and I have to start calling you names. It's like my brain has a little bit of a hiccup, you know it? Do you know what I'm saying? I think Mr. Trump rubbed off on me a little bit. But, you know, I'm just doing the Lord's work. I'm just trying to help people understand who they're voting for. You know what I'm saying? Because ain't no way that someone could know who they're voting for if they're voting for her. You know what I'm saying? Do you know what I mean? Yeah, of course you do. So, yeah, it is hard for me to just say what I don't like about her. If someone says they're voting for her, I have to start arguing with them. I don't know why. I just don't know why. I don't know why. I just don't know why. Somebody on Facebook was sitting there talking about how, you know, Hillary's been doing all this work for all these years and years. And I'm sitting here thinking, well, ain't you seen The Apprentice? Trump's been working for years and has plenty of experience about running a business. Something Hillary don't know nothing about. So as far as it comes to experience, Trump's got the experience. That fancy type of experience. I mean, he's a New Yorker man. And if you can make it in New York, I'm sure you could make it in Washington. Now, as far as all these people saying Hillary's qualified, what about all them emails? Oh, it scares me to death to think of that woman in there. But when I think of Trump in there, I feel awfully safe. There's just something about, you know, a nice orange-looking man with a nice lollipop-sized head with blonde hair on it that just comforts my soul. Excuse me, I've got something to say. This is Penelope. Now, I just woke up this morning, and I ain't even had time to get ready, so please excuse the appearance, honey. Got that tattooed makeup on, but I ain't had time to put on my real makeup yet. Now, all them people posting all this Hillary stuff on Facebook, oh, I know. As soon as you hear politics, you want to X out the video. Well, I agree with you. I wholeheartedly do from my itty-bitty heart. But when you post something on your Facebook, I feel I have every right to jump in with my itty-bitty opinion. I'm just doing the Lord's work. I don't think the Lord would want us voting for that woman. The Lord would want us voting for somebody that includes everybody, the way Trump does. I mean, he's got a nice looking family and plenty of money in the bank. I'd like to be Melania myself.
That when a young black life is cut short, it's not just a loss. It's a personal loss.
That's
it's
right.
A national loss.
That's right.
It's a loss that diminishes all of us. What a blessing tonight to be standing here so that Sandy can still speak.
Yes.
Through her mama.
Yes. Yes. Absolutely. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Wow. Wow. Yes. Sandy speaks. Yes, yes. Yes.
And what a blessing it is for all of us that we have the opportunity. If we seize it, we gotta seize it.
Wow. I mean, what a history-making moment. First female presidential nominee. She's no longer a candidate. She's a nominee. What an amazing gift to all the girls out there who are watching this. You know, young women who struggle to climb up the ladder, and now they see that. What a beautiful moment. What a beautiful moment. Put aside everyone's personal issues. Oh my gosh, this is history. This is herstory. This is for every little girl out there who wonders what she can achieve. What a beautiful, astounding moment. And for Bernie to do that, to unify, I know that had to take a lot. I will never forget this moment as long as I live. Beautiful. Listen, I have no shame in the fact that I gotta have one for my thirst. You know, something icy, something to wash it down. And then I have to have one for dessert, for my crown. Listen, I don't got a man to spoil me. I'm gonna spoil my damn self. I need some sweetening in my life.
And this bread tastes good as a motherfucker.
What are you saying?
Corn in the cob.
Is that what Mamaw cooked?
Two. She got taters.
Taters and what?
Corn.
Huh?
Corn.
Corn what?
Corn.
Corn on the cob? Can you say it again?
Corn in a cob.
Corn in a cob? Sounds like a Hakuna Matata.
Corn in the cob.
And what else did she cook?
Potatoes.
Anything else?
About, I don't remember what all.
Fish?
Fish.
I might go in there and eat in a minute. I'm not too in the mood for torn on the top.
That corn is made in the garden.
That corn's made in the garden?
Yeah.
Okay, tell Mama I'll be in there in a minute. I'm relaxing right now. Bye, cornhead.
I love you so much. I would catch the gingerbread man for you. I love you so much that I will rub your feet even if they make me puke. I love you so much that I would only eat fast food 7 days a week for you. I love you so much that I love you as much as I love myself. I love you so much.
I'll start shutting the door when I'm pooping.
That's love, baby.
Every single one of us is going through something in our lives that only we deep inside know how we feel or what we're exactly going through. And it can be hard when there's bigger issues in the world and dealing with our own problems and everything. But I just want to say, never feel guilty for taking, you know, time out for yourself, whether it's just a drive down the road listening to your favorite music that takes you back to your childhood or to your happy place, or meditating, reading a good book, whatever it is that makes you feel a little more yourself. It's good to feel a little more ourselves each day. And I know a lot of people are busy, have kids, and they don't have time for that. And to those people, even if it's just inside your head, like just saying something to calm yourself down, I just want to remind everyone, it is okay not to be okay. We're all human. And remember that when skies are gray, you were put here to slay. I love y'all.
What's my advice to all the guys out there? You know, to keep a woman happy, to keep a man happy, I don't care if you're gay or straight, but you gotta know how to provide something, and I'm not just talking about money. I'm talking about nourishment. You need to know how to nourish your partner's body. I'm talking about cooking. If you don't know how to cook, you should start to feel a little shook, because there's certain men out here, we like to provide for our partners. You know what I'm saying? If you don't know how to cook, you better at least know how to pay. Get a little something on a fork and go like this to your partner and go, here you go, baby, after a long day. Let me give you the airplane. Here comes the airplane. Now you play the stewardess. You see how that pays off? You gotta take care of your partner. It's a two-way street, unless you got two left feet. Bon appetit, baby. Quit being so lousy, man. Sweetie, I just don't know what I'm gonna do without ya. You're just totally awesome. No, I think it's great we can still have a relationship after the breakup, but you'll always be my little snickerdoodle. Honestly. Honestly. You're so fantastic. Well, look at you. You're a great girl. You're totally awesome. I'll always love ya. All right. Yes, I'm still going to help you with the dry cleaning, because, you know, there's certain things that can't break a bond. All right, but I got to go. My new girl is here, but I'll do your laundry for you still. All right. I'm a good man. All right. This breakup is just, you know, a roadblock. I hope you find love. All right. All right. He'll never be as good as me, though. Alright then, see you, friend.
Libra.
I mean, I guess as long as he's happy now, then I can be happy for him, because what made me happy was making him happy. So, like, now that as long as he's happy, then I can be happy for him, and then hopefully he can be happy for me. I'll always love him, but I wonder if he'll be happy without me. Should I be happy without him?
Scorpio. I can't even believe the time, the years I put into that little piece of a piece. Not even a piece. A piece of a piece of shit. I'm not gonna let them know the pain I'm going through.
Sagittarius. Can you even believe what he was wearing today on his Instagram? You know I'm not letting him know I'm lurking on that girl. I'm just gonna pretend and make fun of him and all that stuff and laugh about the whole fucking thing. Well, laughing's the only thing that keeps you from crying, honey. I'm making fun of him.
Capricorn, well, you know what? I've lost better before. I'm going to focus on myself and my business now. Aquarius.
Okay, but, like, you're my friend. I need you to lurk his page because I don't want to secretly click like on anything.
Pisces.
I tried not to think about it, but then a song came on the radio. And now I'm hugging our favorite movie.
Aries.
Mm-hmm. I heard he's at the club, too, so I'm gonna bring a cutie with me and pretend I don't even know he's there.
Taurus. The worst part of the breakup is enjoying certain foods that remind me of him. Gemini.
Mm-hmm. And he thinks I'm really tripping. I'm not really tripping. My other personality was in love with him, not me.
Cancer. Well, you know I'm paying his phone bill still, right? So I got all his texts printed out from the phone company.
Leo.
Did you see the new bitch that he's with? You don't think she's as pretty as me, right?
Virgo?
I guess someone else will help him file taxes and pay his bills and treat him like the child he was.
Oh, I'm resting. My poor body. Going a mile a minute. Lord of mercy. I was walking so fast through at Walmart in my little shoes, I had to lay on down and take a bunny nap. You know, even bunnies stop hopping for a minute in the forest just to rest their little heads. Ain't nothing wrong with a nap. Ain't nothing wrong with a nap. Even cats do it. Ain't nothing wrong with a nap. It ain't laziness, it's just taking a break from the craziness. I'm as fabulous as a canary, always flapping my wings. And besides, if I didn't nap, I would be fabulous, less fabulous. And we can't have that now, can we? I'm gonna lay my eyes on down, sweetie.
Okay, I'm gonna open this fortune cookie. Some fortune cookies. Need that. Okay, let's see what this is. Fortunate for your thoughtfulness. It says, fortunate for your thoughtfulness.
Now, wait a minute. That's how they are fortunate for my thoughtfulness. Where the hell is my fortune? That's someone else's. You're fortunate and I'm thoughtful.
Damn it.
So I should be fortunate that you're fortunate of my thoughtfulness. What about yours? You wasn't even thoughtful enough to give me my fortune. Throw a penny in the well. You don't have to thank me.
Oh my God, changing your phone number is such a rush. It's like jumping out of an airplane, going bungee jumping. I feel like the king of the world! Or at least the king of the telephone pole. It's like, no, I get to decide if you have my number. You weren't there for me, always calling me late night. What do you think of this? Now I get to watch you squirm a little and see how you are happy living your life without my phone number.
I mean, I'm not on a power trip or anything.
No, it just feels freaking cool, man. I like it.
It's like, no, you can call your other friends. I'm cool. I'm chilling.
The idea of them texting and me not texting is just, like, so fun.
I mean, I'm not talking about family or anything. I'm just talking about people that don't appreciate you.
And when it's late at night, you're feeling a little randy.
This number has been disconnected.
Many people point out that I've gained weight all the time. They point it out like it's something I don't know. It's crazy because years ago I had a really bad relationship with food and I was constantly obsessing over never gaining weight. And the truth is, whether the battle's within you or other people critiquing you, you can never win with other people when it comes to appearance. It's hard enough winning with yourself and feeling confident with yourself. But lucky for me, my confidence doesn't come from the scale. It can go up, it can go down, but my confidence stays the same. Because I know that confidence outweighs weight. If the person I'm dating likes me because of my weight, they have a hard road ahead because it fluctuates. That's why I refuse to see myself through other people's eyes. We have to see ourselves through our own eyes and behold our own beauty. Confidence outweighs weight.
I am never leaving the house again without looking in the mirror first. I was craving my Starbucks so bad this morning. I just threw on some pants and hit the door. Just had a conversation with the barista at the window about how I just, you know, went to the 98 Degrees concert. And I could tell she was looking at me awfully, you know, pensively. And so I get home, you know, I look in my car window just now. When I'm home, I finally decide to look at myself. And I look like I just ate the Pink Panther's ass. I am so embarrassed. And she's just, you know, I was having a regular ass conversation. A regular ass conversation. Looking like the Pink Panther done sat on my face. Never leave your house before looking at yourself. Damn. Like, have a girl talk with yourself. Even if you're not a girl.
It just sounds better to say girl talk. Like, having a boy talk, that sounds boring. Anyway, that's what I call my little stop and pause routine. Because when we get caught up in what we're upset about, we just keep going. Right? If you don't have a shoulder to lean on your own damn shoulder. Be your own friend. But don't get lost in the bad times. Get through them. But remember to check in with yourself. And remember that when skies are gray, you were put here to slay. The bad times don't define you, baby.